Hi, this is Theo and his Vitus Nucleus 27 and a half. Okay, so this is your bike?
Yeah, this is my bike.
I got exactly the same bike, but it's down in Spain actually. But my bike is it's a 29er and perhaps 1 or 2 years older than yours. Yeah. So, why did you buy this bike?
I was in my second year of university and I was in need of a new bike. I had an old 26-inch Scott, okay, which I had for like 10 years. So that definitely outgrew me. So I was in a mood for a new bike and I hadn't all the money in the world. So I bought something which fit my range. Yeah. I was not really into mountain biking at that point. I didn't know anything about what the recommendations were or which gear to have. So I opted for something which was popular on the internet, basically. So.
Did you look at some other bikes rather than this?
Not sure. Like, I was pretty set on this because it fit my budget. So and got like good recommendations. Maybe something from like a local bike store.
Yeah.
But then the price was too big to not opt for. So I went for this.
How much did you pay then?
Like 5,400 Swedish crowns, right. So 550 euros.
Yeah, it's like with mine then. So my bike, that's a 29er, but I noticed that this is a 27 and a half inch bike and you're quite a tall guy with an XL bike. So why did you go for this one?
So for the reason for that, basically the bike was sold out. So I had to opt with what was available.
Yeah.
And as I said before, I wasn't really into like the whole details of the mountain biking world, so I thought like probably suits me.
Yeah.
And it's been a great bike since then. I mean, I've tested some 21-niners,
yeah. And
of course they feel a lot better, or like a bit better. But what can you do? It does the work for me. So.
Yeah, and I imagine this is a bit more playful, perhaps.
Yeah, exactly.
Than my bike, maybe, I don't know. And you've done some modification as well to it, I see.
Yeah, so the first thing I went for was a dropper post with 150 millimeters.
Yeah.
Since I'm a pretty tall guy, I need something that was easy to handle. And since I was really into trail riding and such when I bought the bike, but eventually I got to know the local trail, so I felt like, okay, this is something that I need, or otherwise I'll fly all over the bars.
My dropper is a brand X as well, 150 millimeters too. And but you got a different dropper lever there, I think.
Yeah,
it's exactly. Bomb trigger.
So when I bought the dropper post, I still had a 2X in the front.
Yeah.
So to be able to both shift and manage my dropper post, I had to buy a separate dropper post lever. From Trek here in Gothenburg, actually.
Okay.
And it works really good. It's a bit slow sometimes, but I don't know, it works.
Yeah, I really like the brand X, actually. I've tested a few,
yeah. And
that always seems to work.
Exactly.
I've tested some others that just get stuck somewhere when it's cold, yeah. For instance. Yeah, right. So you went for CN speed in the front there?
Yeah, I bought a cheap 32-tooth chain ring from Amazon. And I got the oval, which I didn't really went for, so that was a fun surprise when I opened the package. But I mean, it felt a bit awkward at first, but I've gotten used to it, and it's actually pretty good, so that's fun.
Our upgrades, I've also done the same upgrades as you have, and I also went for the oval, but I made a conscious decision there. But I really feel it's, with an oval chainring, you have an extra gear, sort of.
Yeah, exactly.
So you can go up a size if you want to in the front there.
Yeah.
Very cool. And you also changed the cassette, I can see.
Yeah, I bought just a cheap chainring in the back because, I mean, the original had like from 11 to 38, so I think. And this is a bit higher, so I can like climb off the steep hills here in Gothenburg. I mean, it's not something I would recommend if you're opting for like minimal weight and stuff.
No, okay.
But then again, I'm a beginner rider, so it doesn't really matter.
All right. So it's still a 9-speed?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's a Shimano Altus?
Yeah.
As well. Yeah. Right. It works, right?
It works. I mean, it does the job.
Exactly. Then you have changed the handlebar. I can see it's got a little bit more rise. Is that a new proof?
Yeah, exactly.
Handlebar.
So that's from an old bike of mine. I wanted some more like rise, as you said.
Yeah.
I just got used to the feeling of more rise, so this felt more comfortable, and I feel like what feels more comfortable gets you more confidence.
Yeah,
so,
cool. Yeah. Absolutely. And you still have the same fork, I think?
Yeah.
XCR, I think mine is an XCR2. 100 millimeters, is it?
I think since mine is 27.5, I get 120 millimeters of travel. So, I mean, it works for like local XCR trails.
Yes, exactly. I get the feeling that there's a fork up front there on my bike, but I'm not exactly sure what it does.
Yeah.
So it's there. It takes the bigger hits, I think, but not that high speed shatter.
Exactly.
So well, perhaps. Yeah, cool. And some flats, of course.
Exactly.
Yeah. Have you done something to your brakes?
No, I feel they're still like factory. I had them re-bled last summer because I went to Isabari and the back brake got a bit tired of me braking too much, I think. So it overheated and then I had to get them serviced. But
Yeah, okay. I actually changed mine. I think it's 160 standard.
I think so as well.
I changed mine to 180 actually. I wasn't happy with my brakes.
Yeah.
So I upped it 20 millimeters. That's about what the fork can take, I think.
Yeah.
And made some difference, but still it's Tektro brakes, so I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, the brakes are definitely the worst part of this.
Yeah. Sort of.
Right.
Coolt. Vänta på dem. Oj, kolla.
Vi kör skogen och så kan vi ta dit
det. Elhojar.
Nej, kör du först då.
Ja, vi cyklar förbi här så får vi med er i film.
Aha.
Ja, bra.
Tack.
Okay, good and bad with this bike, you think?
So, I'd say the worst part of this bike is my skills as a rider. No, but on a serious note, I'd say like the brakes, because they can't handle the pressure as much as I wanted. And I mean, since I haven't really gone down like proper, like harder trails, I can't really say about the parts overall and how they are used to like in rougher conditions.
Yeah.
But I mean, the fork could be upgraded. And since I did something with the gears, I definitely say that maybe, I mean, they worked or as a standard, but having a single chain ring in front is definitely much more convenient.
Yeah, right.
Good. The best part of this bike is probably that, I mean, it's a capable beginner's bike for the money you put into it. So it's good to get you into the sport, and that's one of the best
things. Yeah. It's value for money, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. The same as I feel. Yeah. So I really miss my bike. I haven't seen it for over 6 months now. So maybe I could take it for a spin later on.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, cool. Excellent. It would be fun to try the 27.5-inch wheels and also that fork with the 20 millimeter extra travel.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Very nice. Okay. riding the Vitus Nucleus for the first time in a few months. Yeah, no rear brake. No front brake either. Yeah, definitely a difference with the fork actually. You can feel those extra 20 millimeters. Doesn't sound like much, but there's a difference there. And really like that oval chainring. Feels like an extra gear. Let's try to climb with this thing. Now it's the lowest gear. I felt that the 27.5 inch wheels, they look so much smaller. But since this is an extra large, and my bike is a large, it doesn't feel too small.